Hello, everybody. This is indeed Nate the Great, and this is ProTalk Wrestling live on Spreaker and live in a Culver's here in good old Wisconsin. And hey, ProTalk Wrestling with Zach Hagenbuescher and Joshua Yeager, you do it good, but I do it better. I'm here with my good man, Spencer. Spencer, good to have you on here, man.
How you doing, buddy?
Doing good. How you doing?
Pretty good.
Oh, man. So we've been actually trying to get you on here for, like, weeks on end, but, you know, weeks, that's fine. I remember I tried to get Joshua on here, and it took maybe months just to get him on here. And actually, I want to make a little one thing clear. Zach Hagenbuescher almost took a shot at me, and they kind of joked about, you know, make it seem like my podcast was like the WCW podcast compared to their WWE podcast. But let me tell you guys something. I actually have had guests on here that people want to listen to, okay? So Zach Hagenbuescher, if I see you next time, I will whoop you. Kayfabe. So we actually decided to come here to Culver's to not only enjoy ice cream and the coolness from the hot weather outside, but also to talk a little bit about Monday Night Raw and Night of Champions. I mean, what a Raw it was. I mean, what were your initial thoughts on, like, everything that went down?
Well, I mean, the fact that Sting started Monday Night Raw again, you know, that sets the tone. You know, Sting, not very active in WWE, but when he comes back, it's always a pleasant surprise. I remember last week, I honestly did not see the whole Sting coming out of the curtain. Didn't really see it coming. I thought Cena was going to pop out of there and kick the crap out of Rollins and issue his rematch clause, but Sting just kind of added the icing on the cake.
You know, honestly, that was my initial reaction too, is that somehow I thought to myself, okay, something's going to happen here. Oh gosh, here comes Cena. He's going to come out here. He's going to find a way to just weasel his way back in. But then as soon as the curtain went up and I saw Sting, my eyes were wide and my jaw just dropped. I'm thinking, holy cow. I knew that they were talking about having Sting. I knew they were actually going to have him in like a six-man tag for SummerSlam, but that kind of got scrapped when Eric Rowan got hurt. And now it seems like they're kind of doing a different six-man tag with the Wyatt family and the, you know, Shield 2.0. But we'll get more into that in a little bit. I honestly thought that the Sting promo, you know, to start off was awesome. But I think that the crowd there was just, they just seemed like they were really, really quiet, where they were really just not, I don't know if they were really, like, into it or something.
Yeah, it seemed like that. You know, when Sting first came out and his music played and everything, you know, you hear the wah! Thing with his intro. Everybody was like, yeah! And they started coming out, and then the arena kind of felt quiet. Like, why? You know, he did the whole woo thing, and it's like, five people did it. And then it's like, it's really quiet for Sting coming out.
compared to WrestleMania, everybody was just eating it up.
Yeah. I don't know. Raw last week when Sting came out, it was a little shocking to see that Tampa was a little quiet.
I mean, this is like the area where you have like all the NXT events and all the NXT, you know, fans who have just, you know, said so many crazy chants like Breeze is awesome, no he's not, Breeze is awesome, no he's not. But then again, maybe they should just stick to like the New York Brooklyn crowd where they just have more chants. Probably more inappropriate chants, but
yeah, stuff that we can't air.
Yeah, sadly. Now I actually remember back when WWE did like the ECW one night stands and the Hammerstein Ballroom. Holy cow. Especially the matchup with Rob Van Dam and John Cena. They just, that was, if you talk about an anti-Cena crowd, that was one of the worst. I mean, so many people could say, like, oh, Toronto was the anti-Cena crowd, and, you know, Chicago was the anti-Cena crowd. I think that the New York crowd at Hammerstein Ballroom was the worst place for Cena to be. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that if he would have walked out the WWE champion, that everybody would have rioted. Everybody would just jump the ring, just start beating the crap, beating the shit out of Cena. But you know,
yeah. Even the crowd at the Barclays Center during SummerSlam was pretty anti-Cena. They had a lot of John Cena sucks chants during his intro song and the whole "Let's go Cena sucks" chants.
They actually, I don't know if you noticed this during Raw, but they actually did have, during Rusev's match with Dolph Ziggler, they actually had a, you know, the Rusev's awesome, no he's not chant going on.
Yeah, I did see that.
It was one of those things where it's just like, wow, I guess people are really starting to get behind Rusev. So many people are thinking, oh, he's going to get buried. He's going to get, you know, he's not going to get anywhere. The people love Rusev, even though, you know, he's supposed to be this, like, foreign villain, like, you know, the Iron Sheik or Nikolai Volkov. Right. Or I don't know if you remember La Resistance when they were always came out there singing in, like, the Canadian national anthem.
Briefly, I remember them, yeah.
Oh, man, La Resistance was awesome. But we'll get more into that maybe a little later on if we have time. But, yeah, talking about the whole thing between Rusev and Dolph, it really kind of escalated last night.
It did. You know, the SummerSlam match, I think, was a little bit of a disappointment to the WWE Universe. I mean, ending in a double countout, yes, I understand that it symbolizes that both of these men just want to kick the crap out of each other and just leave nothing left, but a double countout, it always in my book, especially during a pay-per-view, if a match ends with a countout, a double countout, or a disqualification, it's like leading a dog to its favorite treat and then immediately pulling it away. I've always thought that a match ending like that, unless it's